Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. First of all, a very happy new year to all of you. Today in this video, I am going to talk about how to install the latest version of IntelliJ IDEA on a Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily run a simple Hello World Java program on my IntelliJ IDEA. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues, you can always put a comment in our comment sections and try my best to help you. Now to install IntelliJ IDEA, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser. And in the address bar, you need to just simply search with IntelliJ IDEA download. And it's going to show you this download IntelliJ IDEA. So you need to click on this link. And this link I'm going to put right in our description. So it's going to, you know, automatically navigate to the official site of JetBrains. And JetBrains only developed IntelliJ IDEA. So here you can see that our IntelliJ IDEA is available for Windows, macOS, and Linux. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to install it on our Windows. So I'm going to switch to Windows tab, and here you can see that we have IntelliJ IDEA Ultimate version is available. So Ultimate version is a paid one. I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to download the Community Edition. Okay, so IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition. So you need to just simply click on this download button and it's going to start downloading. So thank you for your downloading IntelliJ IDEA, and here you can see that our download is rightly started, right? So I'll just simply cancel this as I have already downloaded it. So I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that we have already IntelliJ IDEA Community version is downloaded over here. So you have to just simply double click on the installer in order to install it locally on your system. And it's going to tell you that the app that you are trying to install isn't a Microsoft verified app, so which is fine. You can totally trust IntelliJ IDEA. So you can just simply click on install anyway, and it will going to ask you for your administrative privileges. So here you need to just simply click on yes, and it will show you this welcome to IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition setup pop-up. So you need to first simply minimize your download directory, and here you need to just simply click on next. So this is where our IntelliJ IDEA is going to be installed on our C program files. It's going to create a JetBrains folder. Then it's going to create IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition folder, and then finally the version number. So this is fine. If you want to change, you can do that by just simply clicking on the browse button, and available space required you can see is 2.4 gigabyte, and available space is 93, so which is fine. So you need to have this much amount of free space for IntelliJ IDEA, right? And then you need to just simply click on next. So here you can see under installation options, we have given so many check boxes. So I'm going to check all the things one by one. So I'm going to select this IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition. So they're going to create a desktop shortcut. Then open folder as project. So if you have any folder which contains any Java project, so if you just simply right click on that folder, it's going to show you this option, open folder as project, which is a very good feature. And you can check this .java, as I'm going to develop only Java related stuff in our IntelliJ IDEA. If you are into Gradle, Groovy, Kotlin, or all these different languages, you can also select all that, including Java, right? And I'm also going to select this add bin folder to path. This is very important. You need to select this bin folder to path, so it's going to automatically set our path in our environment variables, which is really important. Okay, after that you can just simply click on next, and this is fine. Just simply hit install, and you can see installation has rightly begun, along with our desktop shortcut is also created over here. So you know, give some time to let it get finished. After that, I'm going to again come back to this video. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our IntelliJ IDEA is rightly installed, and it is asking whether you'd like to reboot your system now or you'd like to manually reboot later. I'd always recommend you to reboot your system now. So just simply click on reboot now and click on finish to reboot your system. So after rebooting your system, I'll be again back to this video. So welcome back. So after successfully rebooting your system, we'll be again landed over to the desktop. So you need to just simply double click on the desktop shortcut of IntelliJ IDEA to launch our IntelliJ IDEA, and it's going to show you that whether you'd like to import your old installation directory, that configuration that you have made, if you have installed it previously. So I haven't installed it previously, so I'll click on do not import settings, and I'll just simply click on OK. and then it's going to ask you about the data sharing. So you can, for the time being, you can just, you know, simply click on don't send, and it might again show you about this firewall is blocking some of the features. So you need to just simply click on allow, and there you go. You can see our IntelliJ IDEA is rightly open. So welcome to IntelliJ IDEA. So let's maximize this. So this is the interface of an IntelliJ IDEA. So I'm going to show you how you can easily create a new project. So for that, you need to just simply click on this new project, and it's going to start detecting our JDK. So if you have JDK, then fine, it's going to automatically detect your JDK, or else you need to click on this drop down and to click on download JDK. So what it will do is it will going to fetch our latest version of JDK and it's going to download it. So click on download and it's going to download our JDK and it's going to install it locally on our system. Alright, so for that you need to have active internet connection. It will going to fetch the file and going to install it locally on your system. So give some time. And you can see that our JDK is rightly installed, the latest version of JDK version 21. So now that path is it's selected perfectly. Alright, so now it's time to give your project name. So let's give the project name as Hello World. And I'm going to select Java only, so which is fine. Everything is fine. Just simply click on create. And it's going to start creating our Hello World project. And you can see that our Hello World project is rightly created, along with that main.java file is also been created and opened over here. So, you know, let's maximize this. And here is our source directory, and then we have our main.java file. So that file is also opened over here. So here they have already given one template. So they are, you know, printing system.out.println hello and welcome. So they're going to print this on our console along with this number from 1 to 5, they're going to print. Like you can see, this iteration is there, right? So, you know, if you just simply do nothing, you just simply click on this run button, so it's going to start building our project. So, run button might not be enabled at the very beginning, you need to give some time, you know, so that it finish our indexing properly, and then you will be able to see this run button getting enabled. So I just click on run button and it's going to start building our project. And once our build gets successful, you can see first it shows hello and welcome, so this message, and then it is printing number from 1 to 5. You can see that number is getting printed. So let's say you want to change this to hello welcome, and after that I'm going to type all the best. Right, and after that, if I just simply click on again this run button, it's going to again start building our project, and after it gets successfully builded, it's going to show you the output, hello and welcome, all the best. Right, this I is coming actually after that, so what I can do is, I can just simply give a space over here, and I'll again click on run button, again it's going to build it, and this time you will see that we have all the best, and then after that only I equal to 1 is coming, right? So in this way you can easily install latest version of IntelliJ IDEA on a Windows operating system. And after that I have also shown you how you can easily run a simple Hello World Java program on our IntelliJ IDEA. So I have also started a couple of channel. One is Geeky Syntax. So here I am going to post some coding related videos. So you know, do subscribe this channel as well. And along with that, I have also started one Geeky Script vlogging channel. So here, I just recently put one Dal Lake video. So Dal Lake of Kashmir. So if you're interested, you can also, you know, subscribe our Geeky Script vlogging channel. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please do like, share and subscribe. That really helped me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.